4 rupees. Once upon a time, there lived a simple villager named Ranga, who earned his living by doing all odd jobs. Clad in a dhoti and a dirty shirt, his eyes looked around for someone who could give him a job that day. Suddenly, Ranga spotted a man looking about. Ranga immediately called out, "Can I help you? Are you looking for somebody?" "I am the servant of a bungalow in the extension nearby," replied the man. "Our brass pot has fallen into the well and I need somebody to take it out." "What will they pay for it?" Ranga inquired. "What will you want for the job?" asked the servant. "I must see the well first, and I can't think of anything less than 2 rupees, said Ranga. The servant signaled him to follow. In order to hurry him, the servant held Ranga by the wrist and dragged him along. Ranga felt a little worried, as he had never gone down a well before.
"Look here, I know nothing about wells," Ranga muttered.
"Oh, don't say that. See the well first. The master and mistress have made life hell for me since the past 4 days. They will send me packing if I don't do anything about it today," replied the servant and continued dragging him.
"But I know nothing about wells," Ranga pleaded.
The servant smiled at Ranga. "Now, none of that with me. If you want an anna or two more, ask for it, but don't try these tricks."
Ranga followed him, much against his desire. Soon they reached the extension bungalow. The master, mistress, and their 2 boys were waiting anxiously at the gate. The mistress was very happy at her servant's achievement. As the duo closed in, the master announced,
"A brass vessel has fallen into the well. You take it out."
Ranga replied apprehensively,
"But how can I, master?"
"Leave it to me, master,"
the servant intervened, giving Ranga an angry look.
"He will do it."
Together, they all walked up to the well and told Ranga how it all happened.
"It is 4 days since it fell into the well, and we don't know how the brass pot just fell like that,"
said the mistress.
"We have been drawing water from the well for so long. The rope must have worn out," Ranga said thoughtfully.
"See, I knew that was the reason,"
the master said promptly. He turned to the servant and thundered,
"How many times did I ask you to change the rope? You never took heed, and now our heirloom is lying at the bottom of the well."
I remember your mother telling me that it was a gift given at your great-grandfather's wedding, and that it has been in the family for 4 generations now,"
the mistress sobbed. She too turned to the servant and scolded him.
"How many times have I warned this fool not to touch the vessel, and yet he does it?"
"Only zinc pots must be used to draw water from the well,"
Ranga intervened with the tone of an expert. Master and mistress together nodded.
"That is right."
The servant and Ranga lifted the cover of the well, and as Ranga took a look inside, his heart sank at the darkness of the great tunnel, beyond which a patch of water gleamed.
"Seems to be very deep well,"
Ranga worried.
"Only 60 feet,
the servant replied scornfully. Planning an excuse, Ranga replied,
"We don't usually go into wells deeper than 40.
"If you want 8 annas or so more, we are not going to grudge it, but we want our brass pot out of the well," said the master.
Ranga thought to himself,
"Well, I have never earned so much in one shot. I need not to work for 3 days, and that wife and mother-in-law of mine, who are really troublesome, can be silenced for once.
But how deep the well looks, and how scary. Wish I were miles away."
Ranga inspected the well and said,
"Well, I must go now. I will come back in the evening,"
the worried mistress asked.
"But why must you go now? Finish the work and you can leave,"
Ranga replied.
"I haven't eaten my lunch."
Master laughed aloud.
"Oh, that's no problem at all."
He turned to his servant and asked him to serve Ranga a hearty meal. Ranga enjoys the feast, as it had been a while that Ranga had enjoyed anything like that. He was even offered betel leaf and asara nut at the end of the meal. Ranga now felt irrevocably committed to the expedition, and after an hour's rest, walked into battle. resigned to his fate. He took off his shirt and tucked it in his dhoti. Then he told the servant to tie the rope lightly to the crossbar of the well and let the other end into the well.
I'm ready to climb down,
he announced. He chanted the names of all the deities he had ever heard about in his heart and wondered, how dark the place is. I can't breathe at all. What if I were to die? Please inform my wife if I drown, he told his onlookers morosely. His last wish was only responded to with laughter.
Don't worry, you will be fine. Just be careful,
called out the master. After going down 30 feet, Ranga was gripped with fear and he called out loud.
Let me come up. I can't go down any further.
Come on, you can't give up now,
motivated the master, promising him 4 rupees. Ranga murmured to himself,
4 rupees? 4 rupees? I'm dying, or am I dead? Will I ever see daylight again? 4 rupees! What a lot of money! But what use is it to me if I'm dead?
As Ranga reached the water, he moved his hand about to feel something in the darkness, and his hands made contact with a piece of rope, and on dragging it up, he found the brass pot attached to it. Ranga announced triumphantly,
I have got it! I'm coming up! Pull me up! I have no strength! I will drown!
The men outside the well pulled up Ranga with all their might, and he lay on the ground trying to overcome both the fatigue and the fear. The master thumped him on his back.
You are a good fellow. We will call you again if anything drops into the well. Where do you live?
Fearing the dark, Ranga replied hesitantly.
Give my wages and let me go.
The master handed him over 4 rupees and 4 anas. Ranga was shocked and pleaded.
You promised me 4 rupees and 12 anas. You don't know how I risked my life to get your brass pot.
Don't go back on your word.
The aghast mistress lashed out at Ranga.
How dare you argue? Is there no limit to your greed? After all, we have given you food and everything.
Weary and disappointed, Ranga walked back to his house. His wife and mother-in-law instantly lashed at him.
It's 7 o'clock. When am I to buy the things and cook the food? You think I'm born to be your slave? It will be a fine lesson if you are made to do without a meal tonight.
Ranga showed them the 4 rupees and 4 anas.
Take this and let me have some peace. I have had a hard day.
Four rupees?
His wife was shocked.
Are you sure you didn't steal it?
You want to know how I earned this money? Ranga replied angrily and showed them his bruises. He narrated how he had gone down 60 feet to find a brass pot at a great risk to his life. Both the wife and the mother-in-law mocked at him and teased him.
Sure, you were never that brave. You have probably pulled it out of somebody's pocket.
Tick the correct option. Fill in the blanks with words from the story. Rewrite the following words as compound words. Use the suffixes given below to create 2 new words with each. Give the correct plural form of the following nouns. Fill in the blanks with the plural form of the nouns given in the brackets.